How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? And welcome back to the Wings Report. I'm your host. Let's go ahead and get right into it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here with Lean, Wings of Redemption, speaking on happiness and my YouTube earnings. Now, you know, Wings is a bit of an emotional person, doesn't mind talking about some of the things that are going on with him without trying to completely exploit himself, but that's neither here nor there. So let's see what Wings is feeling in this YouTube earnings thing. I'm definitely interested in this because, as you guys know, DSP is usually talking out of his ass about how much money he makes on YouTube and this, that, and the third. And it's total bullshit, by the way. But Wings, I feel like, is a good marker to get an understanding of the type of money that DSP has made and possibly what he is making on YouTube. So this will be a nice little measuring stick to give us a kind of an idea. And let's see how Wings is feeling. I'd like to think he's doing better. He doesn't weigh nearly as much as he used to. He's been getting out more, spending a lot of time out with friends or family or whatever the case may be. Some people think he might have a job. Who could say? He is starting to stream a little bit more or a little bit more consistently. So that's a thing. So I guess we'll just go ahead and wait and see what he has to say. Should be interesting. And yeah, guys, I'll see you guys literally in just a second.
Hey, dude. Yeah, I was bored. Nobody was on. I figured
All right, guys. Yet again, we're here with Lean, Wings of Redemption, speaking on happiness and my YouTube earnings. Here we go.
Pop on and grab some people to play some fucking Rainbow. Get some fucking casual wins. It's not even things, white boy. I mean, like, money can't buy you happiness. If money could buy you happiness, people like Robin Williams wouldn't have committed suicide. Attention doesn't buy you happiness. Happiness only comes when you're satisfied with yourself and where you're at. Happiness is a choice. You gotta decide that you're gonna be happy. You know, again, in itself, is complex.
Yeah, I was like, about to say, it's not as cut and dry as you have to decide to be happy and you're just going to be happy. That doesn't work that way. And I think with Robin Williams, I can't speak completely on it because obviously I didn't know the man, but it's I think it's a pretty fair saying that the people who try the hardest to make others laugh are usually the ones who are the most tortured or who are have it the worst and whatnot. And I think him choosing to be an entertainer and going to the lengths that he did to bring joy to people is so other people didn't feel what he felt. But that's just my own personal opinion, of course.
Everything's complex. There's no easy answers. Why am I not happy? I wouldn't say so far say as I'm unhappy. I'm just, there's things I'm disappointed in life. Like, I'm 33, and I thought I'd be married by this point. Lexapro is not addictive, and it doesn't really... I don't know, I don't drink alcohol, so I don't... nothing really enhances it. You act like I need it.
Ben Killer. Did you already know you get
well, off? To be fair, Wings, I've seen streams that you've come on and taken your Lexapro, I think is what it's called. He almost does it immediately. And I'd say it's probably a much more enjoyable stream, whereas if he's taking it earlier in the day and it's starting to wear off or so on and so forth. That's just my personal observation, of course, but I'm not saying that he's addicted to it. I would say that things seem to work out a little bit better when he's on it. But I wonder if it's habit forming, though. Because, I mean, being addictive and habit forming are two slightly different things, so I don't know. We're kind of splitting hairs at that point.
But ain't that bad. I'm only 20 and I don't have a plan in life. School's expensive and work don't pay enough. Make the best of what you can, my guy. Could be much worse.
As it pertains to him thinking he should have been married by now, I think one of the things is it's Wings' lack of interaction with women have been the major problem, because the ones that he have been with have been abusive or or certainly have taken him for the gusto. I think it's probably a good thing he didn't get married early, to be honest with you. I wouldn't have wanted to see Wings with two kids, a wife that's running around getting black, and he's paying for his home and paying for hers, with another dude in there, and him stuck with the kids while she out there, you know, ripping him for every bit that he got. I'm kind of, I don't know. Maybe that would have been a blessing. Maybe he should have had some kids, had a messy divorce, and then, you know, he learns about it that way. I don't know. I feel like the stress levels are going to be too much for him and whatnot. Ned, excuse me, I don't wish divorce on anybody. So, I don't know. I think that he's still not that old. You can always get married, man. You can still always have kids. Hopefully he's not trying to talk himself out of it, but if he's not ready for kids or if he doesn't think he can handle kids, then so be it. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't sound like he's doing it to be necessarily selfish. I think it's because he's more unsure than anything. But that's neither here nor there.
I'm in no position where it's like I feel like I'm at the worst in my life. Like, I'm actually feel like I'm at a seat of privilege in a lot of things, because I'm going to be debt-free by the time I turn 34. And that's more than a lot of people can say. Could it be better? Sure. Could it be worse? Most definitely.
That's actually. Yeah.
What you been playing?
Destiny 2 and Rocket League, actually.
Dude, if I go to Area 51, it's gonna be in a food truck, and I'm gonna be selling $9 bottles of water, letting y'all motherfuckers know. Red Eye, first donation of the day. Yeet. Thank you, Red Eye. Ben Killer said, Jordan, I know you get a lot of shit. My bad. I'm only 21, and I don't have a plan in life. Life isn't about plans, dude. Honestly.
I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. I don't know when this video came out, but it's this had to have been from a little while ago though. Maybe not. Because when he brought up Area 51, I was thinking, you know, that silly ass plan that's supposed to be going down in September, but a bunch of people are gonna try to ninja run out to Area 51 and get shot down like shooting fish in a barrel. I was wondering if he was alluding to that. And if that's, and let's say this was a couple months before that. Like I said, I don't remember exactly when this was posted. That's a pretty good foresight. That's a pretty good foresight on Wing's part. If that's the case, of course. I'll leave the link of it down in the description, as I usually do, so you guys can check it out without my annoying voice in there. Oh, boy.
Enjoy yourself. Just do what you do. Do what you need to do to make you happy and to try to keep a roof over your head. And we have this dude named Fenway Funetes talking about Brandy's new boyfriend, Tyrone. I haven't talked to Brandy since, like, 2014. I don't give a fuck what she does. I don't even know if she has a boyfriend or not. And he had $5 for Brandy, sweet ass. Merxy donated $1. Hey, Pimp, I was wondering if you could give me a PSN of whoever carried you to Diamond. Nobody carried me to Diamond. Have ever tried appearing Area 51, the CD Master of Armor. Thank you guys for the donations. I've been seen in a brand new Ford Raptor. Shit, I would like to see these pictures, because I don't remember being in a brand new Ford Raptor.
Ran in on me.
I'd rather weigh 245 pounds than have a Ford Raptor.
I don't know if Wings always did that or not, but right whenever he gets surprised by an opponent is when he does that. That shit's fucking hilarious. I need to clip that shit out and use it for something one day. That shit's hilarious. Said that Snorpedal or something. That'd be hilarious. Oh shit, that'd be godlike.
Aren't you getting close to Wayne now?
Actually, I should send it to, I should send it to Snorpedal, but I should definitely send it to Mighty D. That'd be funny. Or James the Lesser.
I'm losing weight again. I'll get there eventually. Why do you think they continue to do it? Like, the people at the top are making money off of it. Like, Lane makes like $1,700 a month just uploading my stream.
Yeah, I bet.
Can you not do anything about it?
I can do plenty about it.
Why don't you?
I'm just biding my time, because right now it benefits me.
More viewers, more money.
Mm-hmm.
But are those the viewers that you would want to have, though?
It's benefiting.
It benefits. It keeps me at the top of the rainbow search.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, because how many viewers you got depends on where you appear when people click on Rainbow Six Siege on Twitch. I am the most popular. I'm the biggest console.
Now, here's the thing. I don't know if he's the biggest person for Siege, but he could be right. I'm not sure about that. But think about it this way. Think about just off of what you just heard on how Wings basically is like, I'm using them, they work for me, whatever, whatever. He didn't say all that. I'm just kind of, you know, I'm freestyling it. Why doesn't DSP think of it that way? Because DSP is thinking about the short term instead of the long term. Like, you know what I mean? Like, Wings has come up with an idea. I wouldn't say come up with an idea, but he's basically trying to maneuver himself into a position where he can at least stay relevant on the platform that he's on. DSP can't do that on either platform, and on either of the platforms that he's on, and there are people making money at least on one of them, and eventually they're going to make it on the second. The way Twitch is going, and has been going for a while, it's not going to be long until somebody, probably a cute pup in a sharp suit, decides to go over there on Twitch and start going to the Just Chat section and start going over DSP videos or detractor videos, similar to how Bad Bunny did it, and I'm not going to get hit. I'm not going to get hit because it's going to be because I'm right there. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm right there in that, like, in that, not really in that safe space, but I'm in a really good position. And he's not going to have much to say, especially when the content isn't original, isn't his. It'll be someone else's. If not, it'll be my own. So that's what the new thing is going to be, and DSP is not going to be able to protect himself from it. So he should try to utilize, he should be trying to utilize these situations to better his position, but he's not smart enough to do so because he wants quick payoffs and he wants the long-term safety. And you can't have both. You know what I mean? And it's reasons like this that low tier God and Wings still are in better positions than him. The only person who's in a worse position right now is Monday Matt, but I don't know. I feel like Monday Matt should be somebody to put him on suicide watch or something before something happened to him. I don't know. He's in a real crazy spot right now. Jesus.
Like, I'm pulling 500 viewers at 3 o'clock in the morning.
That's crazy, though, that Lean makes that much just off your videos.
That's funny, because DSP can't hit that in prime time. In DSP's prime time slot, he can't hit 500 people unless it's drama-based. Holy shit, that's hilarious.
It's not even editing, it's just clipping stuff.
Yeah, he just downloads the whole stream, clips out what he thinks is funny, renders it together, and uploads it. It's no effort.
You'll have the people that just... I mean, you'll just have, like, the parts that he does edit out. It'll be like, oh, shout out to Sean Franklin. Like, that's the parts that he gets, mm-hmm. So...
I might be a big streamer, but I suck at Siege. I don't suck at Siege. If I sucked at Siege, I wouldn't have like 4 or 5 different groups that always invite me to go play rank with them. Ban Dead Feet Father, please. I'm bad, but you're the one sitting here at 3:30.
I mean, sometimes you just need a body, to be honest. And two, you're someone who's eager to play, so that's a good reason to keep you up. You know what I'm saying? I remember when I started playing Call of Duty, I was a horrible player. I'm still not that great now. At least I don't think so, but I'm better. But I'm not as good as I feel like I should be. And people still invite me to. Especially Black Ops 2, because I love Black Ops 2. And I still have friends on 2 consoles, respectfully, that still play it. Because, goddammit, the game's fucking amazing. And they still invite me to play. And I enjoy doing it. You know what I'm saying? You just get better over time. But that's not... they're not inviting me because I'm going to put up 50 kills. That's certainly far from the case. You know, if I get 35, you know, that's a good night. that's a good night. But it's not because of that. It's because I'm a team player. You know what I'm saying? I play my position. I know my part. You know what I'm saying? I stick to the motherfucking script and I have a good time with it. I don't like raging. I like having a good time. And maybe that's the reason why they really invite Wings, not because of his prowess. Not to knock, you know, Wings' abilities. I just don't think they're as high as he says they are.
Morning spamming racist shit in my chat. Go away, dude. Crystal meth. Smell me, big burn. Big bruh, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, Holmes. Shot him out, Sean Ranklin. My lord and savior, Sean Ranklin. Thanks everybody for coming out to the stream. Thanks everybody continue to support me. Hope everybody has a wonderful evening. I'm gonna go get some sleep. Hope to see you guys next stream. Peace, people. What is an impossible whopper? What is that supposed to be?
Oh boy, that was actually a rather short one. That's not too bad though. I'm not too angry at that. I'm not too angry at that, actually. You know what? I'm gonna do it because I love y'all. So here we go. We're gonna actually combo this one into it. It's gonna be fun. So this one, right here. Let's see. Hopefully that'll be good. I might have to resize it in a minute, but I think we're where we're at. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let me go ahead and walk you into what we're about to do right here. We are here with the man, the myth, the legend, Sean Ranklin. Wings of Redemption wants to buy another Mustang. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, I picked this out, and since the first one was so short, then we can just combo this together. It works out. So our boy Wings has been looking at getting himself another Mustang. Now at this point, this is relatively recent too. This video only came out yesterday. I think it was on the 11th or the 12th of August. He's been doing pretty good for himself at this point. You know, his streaming is going pretty well from what I've been hearing, and so on and so forth. And he doing all right. He's shining over there. He's glistening a little bit. So he's been talking about maybe wanting to get himself another Mustang. Supposedly he's ready to sell his truck, which is the same truck that he's been having some issues with, which, you know, basically caused him to buy the first Mustang. So, you know, let's go ahead and hear what our boy Wings got to say about it. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to our boy Sean Ranklin. It should be entertaining. Here we go.
To be. People say they want an Impossible Whopper. I've seen a picture of one, like in a wrapper. Is diabetes in a wrapper?
I think I want to upgrade to a V8 Mustang. Would you upgrade to the V8 Mustang?
Depends
on what?
You don't want a Mustang.
The local Ford dealership got a 2018 GT base in with the 10-speed automatic, and you know that thing's supposed to go 0-60 in 4.4 seconds. Well, they just came out last year. Like GM and Ford made the transmission together. It's what's going to be in the new Corvette and everything. They want 32.3 for it. I probably can get them down to 29 just by talking. And then, like, I could sell my Mustang for $6,000 or $7,000. And then if I save my money up and put another $5,000 with it, that'll put it down to like 17 and then finance 17 for 5 years.
Jordy.
Now, hold up. Okay, so we talking about all this money. Let's go ahead and get some things. Out there. When he bought his Mustang that he currently has, red with the racing stripe and everything like that, can't remember how much he said he bought that car for. I think it was somewhere between $8,000 and $10,000. So, and he kind of came out of nowhere with that. Not necessarily. He was leading up to it. He was talking about it, and I guess a few of the trolls ended up finding out who the person was who had the car. And they may have contacted them or sent them some text messages. Who knows? Either which way, Wings ended up buying the car. It was a salvage. And a lot of people, I remember, I think Kyle from PKA had said that he had paid quite a bit of money. That's a lot of money to pay for a salvage. I feel the same. I feel that's quite a bit of money for a salvage title. But it is what it is. I don't know if Wings could resell it for that much money. Because I remember Wings was talking about it when people were like, well, if you were ever going to sell your salvage, how much do you think you'd get it for? And he said he wouldn't be able to get as much as he paid for it. And what he's saying right now is right around what he paid for it. I don't know. Hopefully, as we go along, we'll get some more clarification. But he already talking about moving that and getting the truck out the way. My thought process is pay your house off, dude, which he's almost there. At least so he says. He's almost done paying that off. Then pay off, pay for the new air conditioning unit, pay for some other things around the house that you could fix it up, you know, kind of spruce it up, if you will, because now you own it. So now, you know, you can do stuff to kind of increase its value. And then I think he already had his mom sign over the deed to him. At least I hope he has at this point. Invest in yourself a little bit before we start going off and getting a new vehicle. If he wants to sell the truck, I get it. I remember him saying he was keeping the truck around to try to, you know, because certain people would help him to haul stuff or so on and so forth, and that's why I kept it around. But if he's ready to get rid of that, then so be it. I think that he should take care of stuff around the house first and maybe put a little bit of money in the bank before we start going after this. But then that's kind of like the Call of Duty mindset. Like when you think about that YouTube Call of Duty money he was making, he could do that. He could do that easy. Now, not so much. And now that I think about it, ladies and gentlemen, he didn't really talk about his YouTube earnings. I mean, I guess you could say him making the reference to what Lean is making. Oh, that's what Lean meant. Ha! My bad, I'm an idiot. Never mind. Shouts out to Lean. So it is what it is. I was hoping Wings would talk more about what he was making. But it is what it is. And even then, it's probably not accurate. Lean probably makes more than that. But anyway, I think Wing should go ahead and take care of his obligations first before we start going ahead and spurging on somebody else on some paper on a new vehicle and whatnot. Especially one that he don't need right now. Like he said, he's going to be 34 soon and he's going to be debt free because I don't think he has any credit cards or anything like that. So this is a good move for him. But get some of the stuff out of the way. You're so close to the finish line. Pay off all that shit first and then worry about it. We'll see. I might be jumping on him a little too quickly.
I get an automatic V8 because the 10-speed automatic transmission is faster than the manual. Because the computers nowadays can shift faster than the human brain can.
You just triggered a lot of people.
It's the truth. Well, obviously the new transmission is a dual clutch system too. Like you can do it, you can shift it manual if you want to, but it's automatic. Like my Mustang currently has that in it. Honestly, if I got something like that, I'd want it just for the sound. Like I love the way the V8 302 sounds in Mustangs. I don't need the V8 either. I mean, like the EcoBoost is like a second slower, and gets damn near 10 miles per gallon more to gallon of gas.
That's way better gas.
Yeah.
Get the Raptor, sell everything you own.
Well, the Raptor's not a V8 either. Raptor's a V6.
It's really a V6?
Yeah, it's a twin turbo V6. What are my thoughts on being called a thief? I've never stolen anything.
No, here's the thing. I just thought about this, but it kind of makes sense if he was willing to do it. You know, there's car channels on YouTube, yeah? Guys who rebuild, you know, engines, guys who do how-tos on how to work on parts of your car, all the way down to the make and model. People who just test drive cars. They're paid by different car manufacturers to test drive their cars and so on and so forth. There's guys in the food community. Dame Drops is someone, for example, who has done a couple of car sponsorships. That's what Wings should do. He should honestly do car sponsorships. And why not? The dude, unlike, you know what I'm saying, certain people that will not be named right now, fuck it, DSP, he can drive. He knows, well, TSP could drive. He just drives terribly. Wing can actually drive and whatnot, and he could have one of his friends or shit, even grandma, because grandma, a gangster, he could have his grandma hold the camera for him while they go test driving on a closed track or something. You know what I mean? It's North and South Carolina. They both, shit, they were known for bootlegging and racing out there and shit. So there's courses there's professional courses they can go that he can go to the test drive cars. He should do that shit. He can read a script. He can tell you everything that they can write down everything that the car can do and all of its features, and he can regurgitate that shit. He should do that. And his channel is still big enough that if he was willing to put like a year or two into that, he could make that happen. You know what I mean? Wings could make that happen. I don't know. Someone should pass it on to him. But I think that's something. I mean, if his love for cars are as much as he says it is, that's a really lucrative way of doing it. And that you get to chill with a nice car for like a month, you know what I mean, before they ask him to take it back or before they come and pick it up, because they'll drop it off to him. He should do that. Cars, trucks, you know what I'm saying, especially SUVs, he could fill that market. That's a market that he could tap into. Just my opinion, of course.
I'm excited for a new Call of Duty. I'm excited for any kind of first-person shooter. They don't really come out that often anymore. Big old Chili Bean wants to know if he's allowed.
What he means is good ones don't come out very often.
Being banned, he said he sent the harmful. His name's Big Old Chili Bean. What do you fucking think? What year's my Mustang? Mustang is a 2014, and I have a Navos. It's designed strictly for my car. If I was to get another Mustang, I'd get like the base model, and just upgrade the radio. Because, like, why pay for things like leather seats and, like, push button and shit like that when you could just upgrade the radio? Like I was looking at the Mustang trims, right? And, like, the GT starts brand new at $35,000 as base. And it goes up to $51,000. The only thing I see different is leather seats and touchscreen navigation worth $16,000 more? I don't think so.
Man, cool.
What year is the V8? 2018. It's got 4,800 miles on it used.
You think it's worth the risk buying used? I never thought so.
The one I'm looking at is only got 4,800 miles. That's pretty much new.
And the one he's driving is a salvage, so it's not like Wings is worried about being safe, right? Oh, shit. Oh, God. I hope that he never gets into a car accident in that car. I really hope he don't. Jesus Christ. That shit feels like a death trap to me. Even if they reinforce the framing, I don't know. I wouldn't have bought a... I wouldn't have bought a salvage. I wouldn't have done that.
It's worth that they're like dragging it light to light. Like if I ever
I'm gonna be dragging it light to light. What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah.
I just bought a car that's got a salvage title on it that had 40,000 miles and has been totaled. I'm comfortable. I know enough about cars to make a good purchase.
I think we're not.
As long as people take care of it, and like there's certain things you can't fuck up very quickly. Granted, you could blow a car up almost instantly if you just go on the lot, and just ram the engine to the red line and just hold it there. Normal driving is not going to fuck too much up. They had a used one with features that normally would be about $38,000. The Empire Sysbex, why don't you deny your name is Sam when there is a video of your mom calling you Sam? There's also videos of my fucking hospital records showing my full name. Go the fuck on. Do I ever plan on starting a family? Probably not. I don't probably plan on having kids.
Don't say that.
I don't. I mean, like, I'd much rather have other things in life.
Yeah, like six cats.
Like what?
Why not?
Like sport?
It's going to be like DSP. Oh, shit. He's gonna have a cat that he's gonna call Jordy and shit. He's gonna bring him on stream to raise his viewer count. That's just fucking hilarious. But then again, I think Wings will change his mind in a couple years. He's still young enough to where he doesn't have to worry about it. But, I don't think he actually feels that way. I mean, if he does, then so be it. There's a lot of people who feel that way. That they don't want to have kids because they feel like their time has passed. We already went over that in one video. Or he feels like he can just have other things too. I think children are a bit more meaningful in the long run, but that's my own personal opinion. That's not something that's shared by everybody.
Materialism?
Like sports cars, like I want a garage. You can't afford to spend 20 grand on a garage and have a family at the same time. It doesn't work that way. The hood is for people that can't afford nice things. I don't believe that. Like in my experience, the hood is for people that don't want to better themselves. Like there's a lot of people that live in
the fuck? The hood is for people who don't want to better. Oh, Wings. Oh man. Wings. Oh shit. That's subjective to be on. I don't know if I'd say it's subjective. I think some people are in the hood because they don't have no choice. Some people don't want to get out the hood because they're comfortable or they're complacent. A lot of people just feel like a lot of people in the hood, it's always where they've been. That's where their family's at. That's where their friends are at. A lot of them choose not to get out. I mean, it depends on what hood are we talking about? Because there are plenty of spots that would be considered the hood, and they're probably safer than any suburb you could think of. Or they don't have the drugs and all the gunplay that the news says that they do, and so on and so forth. Not every hood has a negative connotation to it. It just doesn't. It doesn't always work that way. And to say that people don't want to leave the hood because they're lazy is kind of silly. Because it's almost like it's like the argument where should they get rid of welfare or not? If you really need to be on welfare, then you should be on there. You shouldn't abolish. And not saying that they're going to do that. You would hope that they don't, because there are people who need to be on it. I would hope that they wouldn't abolish welfare just so the people that they feel that are undeserving of it get knocked off. That seems kind of silly. And I know that might seem a bit harsh coming from someone who shits on DSP for begging for money each and every day. But a lot of people that are on welfare, despite their skin color, despite their backgrounds, is in a really bad spot. And it's a way of kind of helping them out. Now, if you're just trying to ride that shit out for everything it's worth, that's a different story. But if you're on it to, give yourself another start, or just get some government assistance until you can make shit happen for yourself, then so be it. And I think when a lot of people look at welfare, I think they attach a certain group of people to it. And I think that's unfair because it doesn't take into account the overall, the bigger picture, if you will. But that's neither here nor there. Same thing with the hood argument. I think that's kind of crazy. But then again, if you look at some of those projects in New York, those project buildings or whatnot. They're slowly but surely trying to push a lot of those people out so they can, because that's $1 million, if not $1 billion projects out there. You know what I'm saying? Like, once they go in and they clear everybody else out, they can go ahead and completely turn those things into billion dollar spaces or luxury condominiums or whatever the case may be. So I think that's something you got to take into account too. But I don't know. I feel like there's way more love in the hood than anywhere. Living out in the suburbs. I feel like in the suburbs, everybody, well, not everybody, most people are scared for what could happen. And that's why, for example, you have so many, if you guys like crime dramas, for example, that's why there's so many killings that happen in the suburbs. Or that's why so many people, not so many, but that's why certain people can end up working over their whole families and then get off on a technicality and shit like that. Evil resides everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Laziness resides everywhere. The manipulators, you know what I'm saying? Sociopaths, they're everywhere. You're no safer here than you are there. You know what I'm saying? A lot of what you see is propaganda. Some of it's true, but not all of it. You know what I'm saying? I think it's just, I don't know, it's a matter of preference. I think people have to look at the bigger picture to actually come to a conclusion. But you guys aren't here for that, and I'm not here to talk about that shit. But that's just my take on it. I don't think everybody in the hood is in the hood because they're lazy. It just seems... It seems lazy. That's a lazy answer, to be honest.
Hood that do
but
so...
Not to say that my answer wasn't lazy either.
Because that's what they're content with. Like, I know a lot of people that don't want to do better in life because they're content with the life that they have. Man, to be honest, like...
One shot.
I mean, in truth, Wings, a lot of people think that about you. You know what I'm saying? Let's go back briefly to what was the point of Wings getting the surgery. Wings was supposed to get the surgery so he could put himself in a better spot to, in turn, go back to school so he could get himself a better job so he could leave YouTube and Twitch behind, or leave the internet behind as a whole. Did he get the surgery? People are still debating on that, but it's very obvious that he's lost a large sum of weight. Does he seem, and he's starting to, you know, get out of his house, get back into society a little bit. I'm talking like he just came out of prison or some shit. But he's starting to get himself out of his house, mingling with his family, mingling, trying to get reconnected with friends, getting back into society. That's a great thing. But does he show the type of motivation, at least from what you see, that he's trying to go back to school, that he is looking for, considering on at least doing some type of internship, because I think he wants to be like an EMT or something. Do you see him taking the steps for those things? Theoretically on stream, no. He keeps, from what I've heard, he keeps making excuses on why he can't do such and such yet. He's waiting for this to fall into place, so on and so forth. That sounds like being complacent to me, man. That doesn't sound like someone who makes moves. It sounds like someone who's waiting for shit to fall into place on its own, without him interacting with the situation, without him intervening. And I think that's a difference. So I think it's very hard to say that people are complacent about a particular situation in their life when you, yourself, do the exact same thing. Just because your circumstances seem slightly different, it doesn't mean that you're still not doing the same thing. Especially when, not to sound like an asshole, if I remember correctly, the $25,000 or whatever it was that was raised for him to get that surgery, that wasn't his money. He asked people for that money. People trusted him and put faith in him to give him that money so he could do right by it. And what does he do? He gets the surgery, or at least he tells us that, and then all of a sudden he got a Mustang. I'm not trying to be a dick. I'm just trying to go ahead and give you guys the whole picture. You know what I mean? Something to think about.
Being able to sleep when I want was the main reason I wanted to work for myself. Hey, not Polisher. You ever jacked off? Come on, man. That's fucking nasty, pimp. Do you buy meat from that special closeout section? No. Motherfuckers act like I buy meat. Is there a closeout section at Wendy's?
Oh, my God. He shot me in my soul.
What's my favorite type of girl? Available.
BBW, that's what we're talking about.
BBW ain't bad, brother. Oh, shit. We're all running out this way, aren't we?
Shit. A BBW suck your dick like a McDonald's milkshake. You motherfuckers don't know about it.
Oh, dude, alright.
Yo, what's your dog's name again? Daisy.
Big Daisy.
Kind of garbage.
Shit, you need to hold the fuck on and put some respect on Daisy's name. Daisy's harder than concrete, son. I'm trying to stream more so I can buy me that V8 Mustang. So we're gonna be streaming more often. Why don't you get a nice car instead? The Mustang GT puts out 460 horsepower, 420 foot-pounds of stock with a huge torque band. I know there's other cars that do
it. I get that, but that's not something that you necessarily need. Let's be honest, Wings. You ain't out there pulling... This ain't Fast and the Furious Wendy's edition or anything like that, bruh. You know what I'm saying? You don't necessarily need all that. They're just saying, why don't you get yourself a car that's a bit more comfortable? You know what I'm saying? I don't know. It is what it is. Wings could have... The thing is Wings could have had, I'm exaggerating a little bit, but he could have had a small fleet of Mustangs 6 or 7 years ago. You know what I'm saying? Or he could have had a Mustang, a nice Corvette, and a nice truck years ago. He chose not to. You know what I'm saying? So it's almost like he's trying to kind of grasp that and relive it now. And that's his choice, you know what I'm saying, to be honest with you. But he could have had all those things back then. He really could have.
But like that seems like fun to me. You're trying to say the Mustang slow?
So quiet.
That is a GT.
Oh man. Oh, I don't know.
That's the bullet special. I mean, that's pretty much stock.
This is so special, and the feeling you get from this sound, from this manual, from this big. Pretty heavy car. It weighs like 1,850 kilos. It's a real muscle car.
Here it goes. Beast mode. 4.5 seconds, 0 to 60. Yeah, that's the video right there. It's the new 10 speed. This is top speed acceleration. It's still 160 miles an hour. 100 kilometers is 60. 260 is 160. This is the stock GT. That's 0 to 160 there. That's in 160 mile an hour is the rev limiter for a GT. My car is...
That came stock? Oh shit. Oh shit. All right. Well, I can't be mad at that.
Probably about 2 seconds slower. 0 to 60, and like it cuts off around 118, so like no, it couldn't match that. You don't really drive them for the speed, you drive them for the sound, because very rarely are you going to do more than like 45 and like your Mustang GT, but you do it for the pull. Like the pull is what you want to pay for, and that's why I was leaning towards the EcoBoost. It'd be cheaper and it'd have almost the same level of pull as the GT, because the GT only puts out 420 foot-pounds of torque. Whereas the EcoBoost puts out 550. I paid 6,000.
Even still, you don't need all that, bruh. Like, it's almost like we just going for stats at this point. Like, practicality and usability is not actually there. You know what I'm saying? unless the Lions Den really be like, you know what, fuck this. And they all come out there to Conway, Conway, North Carolina? And come out there in force. And he literally has to throw Harriet and his grandma in the car and have to outrun all these motherfuckers. Outside of that, you don't need all this, bruh. It sounds like it's... Don't be wrong. It sounds extremely nice to have. But you don't need all this.
$1,000 for my car. Like, I did all the math. I have about 9,200 in it right now. It's like this Mustang I'm talking about. That's just a pipe dream, honestly. Like, after I get the house paid for. Like, I'm probably not going to do anything else to my car other than maintenance stuff. I'm thinking about selling my truck to go and pay my house off. 2002 Silverado. Bo Democrat was never in the market. How much I owe my house? $6,300. I could probably get about $7,500 off my truck.
And I could, God, this map is in,
right? I can use that to pay my house off. My truck is a very, very low mileage 2002.
5 seconds to go.
It's got 148,000 on it.
A Vigil right here.
And it's also four-wheel drive, leather, a whole nine. I never understood why I can't get the mechanical skill of this game down, though. I feel like I should be a better fragger than I am, and I watch other people that get more kills than me consistently, and I don't know what I do different than them. I feel like I'm too passive. That's the big thing. But at the same time, it's like I don't know how to be aggressive.
But you
so I have garbage reaction time.
Your drone lot of
I don't think that's it.
Your reaction time isn't great. His reflexes might be better, but I don't think his reaction time is very good. And he might be too passive, to be honest with you. I think it mirrors his personality, kind of. Sort of. I mean, unless he's amped up.
Well, I've been losing viewers for like almost an hour now. It's like I went from like 450 to 320.
I saw your stream yesterday. I kind of felt bad for you when you did solo queue and casual. Those like four guys kicked you out there.
Mm-hmm.
I was watching that.
I get that off stream too. Like, I get team killed all the time off stream.
You ever like try? Does that happen when you play alone?
Yeah.
You can't even play this game alone, or you
for the most part, no. Controls. Big Jimbo, when Modern Warfare comes out, you and Kyle 2v2 and stream for charity, forced to work together for a few hours. Good for you, good for viewers, good for charity. Motherfucker, I'm a charity case. What the hell? That fucking Mustang GT ain't gonna pay for itself. The Empire sniffs back. Again, thank you for 5.
Hey. That was pretty funny, actually. I also agree. Like I said, sorry about the choppiness on that. My bad. I'll eventually figure that out. To be honest with you, him doing a 2-on-2, a 2v2 with Kyle in the new Modern Warfare would be kind of dope, to be honest. I think that'll be a good look. And I think one of the game modes is like 50-on-50. Something crazy like that. So that's gonna be a total camp fest, but that's neither here nor there. As it pertains to wanting to buy a new Mustang, it's wishful thinking. He might have. The thing is with Wings is a lot like DSP, in the fact that he's a bit unpredictable. I wouldn't put it past Wings that he would do it. I wouldn't put it past him. I'd like to say that he won't, but common sense prevails, and he may just pop up with a new Mustang one day. It is what it is. All I ask is, Wings, you said you owe about $6,000 on the house. Then you have to buy the new air conditioner, which you said is what, another five? What did you say? That was like another $5,000 for the air conditioning unit, and so on and so forth, because of how big his home is. So let's say another $12,000. Get that stuff taken out, taken care of first, and then consider getting a Mustang, dog. In actuality, you should be putting that money away for school. You could completely I remember he said something about he wanted to repaint the house. He wanted to have brand new carpet laid through the house, or wood, or tile, whatever it is. Like, I don't know. That right there, it seems like a better investment in the long term over than just buying a brand new car, or even another used Mustang, if you will. But ladies and gentlemen, that's his own money. Let him do how he wants to do it. If he does do it, we're going to report on it, because I'm kind of back in the swings of it. And I feel pretty good. I enjoy going over Wings content and whatnot, so it's been fun. I'll have to get into this whole get a Wings report thing going. I'll eventually work on that and whatnot. I'll have somebody in-house here to do it. But we'll get it worked out eventually. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Wings Report. Thank you very much for listening in. I very much appreciate it, and I'll see you guys for whatever the next situation is going to be. He had some chilly catastrophes a little while ago. I might go over those because they're kind of funny. And I know a couple of you were asking, hey, would you consider going over the video where Wings actually goes into the lion's den and confronts his detractors? I think he's done that twice. He may have done it 3 times, but I think he's done it twice. I'm thinking about doing those. I'm thinking about going over those 2 videos. I give Wings at least enough credit that he was willing to do it. DSP would have never have had the balls to do that shit. Ever. Ever. So I give Wings that. So maybe I'll go over those next. So look out for those. Sometime in the future, I should end up going over those. But thank you guys very much for listening, and I very much appreciate it. Shouts out to Lean, Conway Conman, Sean Ranklin, and everybody else over there in the Wings community and whatnot. Like I said, I'll leave the link to all the videos in my description so you can check them out. And I'll see you guys for whatever comes next, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Wings Report. I've been your host. I'll holler at you guys later. Peace.